construction doesn't have a choice. It's in a stage that it has to make a change to survive, and also it needs to respond to rapid urbanization. Right now, it's 1/3 of the world CO2 is produced from construction. 1/3 of the world waste is from construction industry. And we are running short in construction workers and building material. Through 3D printing especially, it will open up new opportunities. I'm Mania Aghaei. I'm architect by practice, specializing in computational design and robotic construction. I'm an assistant professor leading DART Laboratory, which is an interdisciplinary research team. We focus on pioneering novel technologies in the realm of robotics and 3D printing in construction. There has been more and more interest in employing 3D printers in larger scale and in construction. 3D printing in architecture and construction still facing some challenges today. Scalability, affordability, speed, even the material that you can print with. The concept with multi-robotic 3D printing is to overcome these challenges. Multiple robots can build much faster or print much faster. They also would allow you to work with multiple material at the same time, meaning that we can print a more complex building part that we didn't have the capacity before. It will make things more affordable. The ability to 3D print high precision buildings with high performance with multiple robots, which means that we can catch up with the speed that is needed, means also the prices of parts or buildings or infrastructure we are building are being reduced. We will be eliminating waste. Obviously, with 3D printing, you don't need formwork. You will also place material precisely, strategically where it's needed. This also means we will be resourceful, so you use less material. And we can recycle material. We could use sawdust that we are throwing out yearly and not using it. We could turn this to a building material. We could eliminate cutting more trees, but rather use the waste that we have right now from other product that we are producing or from our own buildings, turn this to a raw material that we are printing with.
In order to meet the challenges of decarbonization, new construction, as well as societal challenges, we need to rethink the whole system of construction and building building design. Multi-robot 3D printing is for sure going to be one of the key pieces of that puzzle.
To me, this is not only the new technology, is a new introduction of a new field within the architecture, engineering, and construction. I think we will see a lot of human interaction with machine, in contrary to the prior time where automation meant replacing the labor.
We absolutely don't want to replace them. We want to harness their knowledge to take some of the tasks that maybe are the more dangerous ones, or maybe are things that could be done in an automated way, and use a smart system to do that. The workers get to be more efficient and working on the more maybe fun parts of the job, you know, the really challenging, really, you know, thought-provoking components. And now they could start to tackle this really big problem, which is that there's just so much building that is being asked of this group of people.
We will have to educate completely new set of future leaders in technology for design and technology for construction. We really need material scientists, roboticists, controllers, designers working together to create this new field. OVPR has mechanisms such as bold challenges that would accelerate team building in a very meaningful way.
Construction and design in the built environment are an integrated problem. So you need kind of larger, much larger teams to work on these complex problems, because buildings are not simple problems.
You can take your research and go to the department, engineering department or business department, and find other professors that are interested to take your technology and expand it in their realm.
Bringing all those people into the room who all truly care about how do we make an impact in this industry, but how do we do it from the perspective of many different stakeholders, not just, you know, an academic. Is really key to that.
Our work with them to envision an establishment of the world leading robotic 3D printing center has been extremely helpful to also rethinking what does this mean for United States, but also across the world.